Alright guys, and welcome to another video. So it goes without saying that faction imbalance is a very important and present issue in Classic WoW. Since many servers on the live servers are very imbalanced in favour of the Horde faction. And today we're going to be talking about whether this is going to become a bigger issue if the Classic TBC servers are become a thing. Just before we jump in guys, if you like my videos please consider liking and subscribing because that really does help out, but anyway let's jump in. So the main reason why so many people flocked to playing the Horde during Classic WoW's launch was mainly because of the racials. Okay, we've got stuff like Stun Resist and Will of the Forsaken, which are infinitely superior racials to the Alliance racials for PvP. When they added the every man for himself racial, most serious PvP players flocked to playing Alliance. Back when I used to play a lot of PvP during Mists of Pandaria, everyone was on Alliance and everyone was playing on the Outland server on European servers, and it was just jam packed with everyone playing human. In my opinion, racials, or the concept of racials, are seriously bad game design for any MMO out there because it's automatically going to present a number of imbalance issues when it comes to class choice and faction choice. They really shouldn't offer gameplay advantages in any shape or form and should instead be cosmetic or fun things like the treasure finding racial for the dwarf. There should be more stuff like that in my opinion. So will it get worse if Classic TBC is released? The short answer is yes. Definitely, and it's something I'm actually quite worried about, to be honest. Not only are the current racials in the game very superior for PvP, and then when TBC is released, the PvP climate will become even more serious with the release of Arena, so more people will be playing Undead for the Will of the Forsaken racial because, you know, it just gives you that little bit of an edge over different arena teams. But not only that, we also have to consider Blood Elves, which are far superior to Draenei when it comes to the racials. Particularly in the case if it comes to the decision to roll a Paladin, since they have a unique seal, which makes, called Seal of Blood, definitely makes Retribution Paladin better for the Horde side, you know, an extra 200 DPS, loads more mana efficiency, and even if you're playing Protection, they will have access to a range pull, which the class doesn't already have, but with the Blood Elf racial they will. It's called Arcane Tap, Mana Tap, and then they also have the AoE Silence, which is generally plays a massive advantage when it comes to tanking because you can interrupt casters, which means that they stop casting their abilities and they're forced to go melee, which just makes it easier to move around trash packs and, you know, adds on bosses and stuff like that. So yeah, Blood Elf Paladins are just basically a lot better. I can only see the issue getting much worse, to be honest, since many servers are already dominated by the Horde. You know, for the most of them it's about 60% Horde, 40% Alliance, if not more, which is very difficult. You know, it's difficult for certain guilds to even get to their raids right now. And, you know, when the Classic TBC is released, I think there's going to be even more incentives for people to play Horde. So, yeah, it's just going to get a lot worse. If Blizzard put their two brain cells together when it comes to game design, they could actually fix this very, very easily with a number of systems that they could put in place, but even this humble YouTuber who knows nothing about game design could come up with in about 20 seconds, and I think anyone with any common sense could come up with a system to fix this issue. Because what is going to happen is most servers will become even more Horde dominated. Alliance players will probably be forced to pay for a realm transfer to the PvE realms, which means the PvP realms will all be dominated by the Horde and the Alliance realms will be crowded with Alliance. You could easily introduce a system that very simply prevents people from making a new Horde character on a Horde dominated realm. What I mean by this is if you don't already have a character on a Horde dominated realm, you can't make one, and you can only make an Alliance character on that realm. So it stops new accounts from making new Horde characters on Horde dominated realms. That is like extremely simple. Like anyone could do that. A private server practice is to have free faction changes with a little bit of a incentive. So This is a bit of an issue because it will remove that authentic feeling of the classic realm, so I'm not saying this is a good idea. At the end of the day, it's just a thought. I wouldn't take this too seriously. But maybe, you know, when you switch to the Alliance, you can get a discount on your flying mounts or a slight reputation boost for maybe a month once you gain level 70. You know, little things like that which could fix the current imbalance issues. They could do something even more drastic and very simply make totally new, fresh servers for Classic TBC. Honestly, the idea of this is becoming a little bit more attractive since it could very easily fix the imbalance issues. If we're all given a fresh level 60 character with a system in place to stop servers becoming imbalanced, like preventing people from creating a character on a faction that is, like, say for instance, 5% more populated than the other, then it will just, you know, make it absolutely perfect. Obviously the issue with this is a lot of people want to progress their current character over to New Realm, so I think it'll be very, very unlikely that they will do that. But maybe they could introduce a system where you can transfer your character that you used to play on like a month later or something, but I don't know. I think Blizzard are probably going to release Classic TBC servers as a direct progression from the current servers. So this drastic measure will probably never be a thing. Although I think the previous thing that I talked about of preventing people from making whole characters is a very simple thing you can put in place with a little bit of an incentive for a free faction transfer. Get this going. Get this on the ball before Classic TBC is released during the pre-patch, for instance. Might have a couple months of pre-patch action. Maybe only a month, to be honest. Get the ball going before these servers launch fully. Fix all the imbalance issues, and, you know, it will be a little bit better, because there's a number of things which are going to be very difficult if you're playing on a Horde-dominated realm as an Alliance member or vice versa. First of all, get into your raids. One of the things with TBC raids is a lot of the raids and dungeons are in the same location. So, for instance, SSC raid is in the exact same location as Underbog, Steam Vaults, and Slave Pen. So that's four instances in the same location with the same meeting stone. And from playing private servers, that area is always very massively contested. It can be very frustrating to actually get in a dungeon in the first place because you're getting killed by, you know, the Horde over time. There's also a lot of daily quest grinds, like the Sky Guards and the Netherwing, that people do to get their cool epic mounts. That's going to be a little bit of an issue because, well, you're just going to get ganked all the time trying to do these daily quests, and it's going to be very frustrating. Again, very difficult for the, you know, some people to actually achieve that goal. Anyway, I think I've talked enough on this issue. Tell me what you guys think in the comment section below. My name is MiniGoblin, to my next video. Ciao.